some glad morning when this life is all our way. God's celestial shore, I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away. Oh, glory, I'll fly away
in the morning.
When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
I'd like to say good evening to everyone. Thank you for welcoming us out to your home tonight through the television. You know, we're just here to have church with you and just uplift the name of Jesus Christ and proclaim His kingdom. We pray that something we do tonight, whether it be in the word or song, that we will bless somebody out there tonight. And if there's anybody out that's watching tonight that hadn't accepted Christ as their Savior, do so tonight before it's everlasting too late. This may be your last chance. And, you know, I'd hate to see anybody go the other way. You know, if you have any song requests or prayer requests, there's a number on the bottom of the screen. You call in, we'll do all the prayer requests and as many as the song requests as we can. Sometimes, you know, we can't get them all in, or sometimes we don't have the songs with us, but we try our best to do them. Just thank you so much for allowing us to have church with you tonight. But before we get into the service tonight, I'm going to ask Brother Darrell if you'll have a blessing on the service.
Thank you, Heavenly Father, once again for another Monday evening. We'll be here, Lord. And thank you, Lord, for the faithful viewers, Lord, to watch us. And pray, Lord, each one of them, wherever they are, that, Lord, you touch their lives, that they be blessed by what they see and hear on the TV tonight. Yes. And Lord, that their lives would each one be changed for the better. And thank you for all you do for us each day in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You know, yesterday was Valentine's Day. And all of us should have told our other halves, you know, that we love them. That was what's a day's for, to tell people you love them. But the one that we should love the most is Jesus.
Amen.
This song is going to be for that. Know how I love Jesus.
There is a name I love to hear. I love to sing its word. It sounds like music to my ear. The sweetest name on earth. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because He first loved me. It tells me of a Savior's love who died to set me free. It tells me of his gracious blood, the sinner's perfect plea. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. It tells me what my Father had in store for every day. And though I tread a darksome path, there's sunshine all the way. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. It tells of one whose loving heart can fill my deepest woe, who any sorrow bears a part that none can bear below. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I believe Kenny and them does that song, the buttermilk song for Kathy Smith at the high school. You all know that?
No.
All right. Kenny, I'm sure you heard that tonight. Kathy wants you to sing that buttermilk song. You can practice a little at the house. Won't hurt anything. And a request for Daryl to sing The Old Rugged Cross for Nathaniel Russell. And request for Ron Bennett to sing Long Black Train for Dakota Tharp. So, folks, we'll place them right over there where you can get to them. And we'll get those in just a little while.
All right. This next song we're going to do is Come and Dine. You know, Jesus invites us to come and dine.
Amen.
Jesus has a table spread where the saints of God are fed. He invites his chosen people, come and dine. With his manna he doth feed, and supplies our every need. Oh, he sweets us up with Jesus all the time. Come and dine, the Master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. He who fed the multitude, turned water into wine, to the hungry calleth now, come and dine. The disciples came to land, thus obeying Christ's command. Oh, the Master called unto them, come and dine. There they found their heart's desire, bread and fish upon the fire. Thus he satisfies the hungry every time. Come and dine, Master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. He who fed the multitude, turned the water into wine. To the hungry calleth them, come and dine. Soon the Lamb will take his bride, to be ever at his side. All the hosts of heaven will sing, will be. Will be a glorious sight, all the saints in spotless white, and with Jesus they will feast eternally. Come and dine, the Master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. He who fed the multitude turned water into wine. To the hungry calleth thou, come and dine.
Amen.
Page 148. The next song we're going to do is The Way of the Cross Leads Home. And that's the only way you can get to heaven, through the cross.
Amen.
If Jesus hadn't gone on the cross for us, we would have no way to heaven. The Way of the Cross Leads Home.
I must need go home by the way of the cross. There's no other way but this.
I shall ne'er get sight of the gates of light if the way of the cross I miss. The way of the cross leads home. The way of the cross leads home. It is sweet to know as I onward go. The way of the cross leads home. I must needs go on in the blood-sprinkled way, the path that the Savior trod. If I ever climb to the heights of life where the soul is at home with God, the way of the cross leads home. The way of the cross leads home. It is sweet to know as I onward go. Then I bid farewell to the way of the world, to walk in it evermore. For my Lord says, come, and I seek my home, where he waits at the open door. The way of the cross leads home. The way of the cross leads home. It is sweet to know as I onward go, the way of the cross leads home.
Amen.
Amen. Yes, it does.
155. This next song we're going to sing is Where Could I Go? You know, when you get in trouble, when things just pile up on you, whatever happens, there's always a place you can go. And that's to Jesus.
Amen.
Where could I go?
Living below in this old sinful world, hardly a comfort can afford. Thriving alone to face temptation sore, where could I go but to the Lord? Where could I go? Seeking a refuge for my soul, needing a friend to save me in the end, where could I go but to the Lord? Neighbors are kind, I love them everyone, we get along in sweet accord, but when my soul needs manna from above, where could I go but to the Lord? Where could I go? Oh, where could I go? Seeking a refuge for my soul, needing a friend to save me in the end, where could I go but to the Lord? Life here is grand with friends I love so dear. Comfort I get from God's own word. Yet when I face the chilling hand of death, where could I go but to the Lord? Where could I go? Oh, where could I go? Seeking a refuge for my soul. Yet when I face the chilling of the end, where could I go but to the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
This time we'll turn it over to the pastor.
Amen. Bless you, folks. Thank you for being here.
Bless you. Welcome.
Bless you. Keep my eyes on the word.
You're doing a wonderful job, Ronnie. We appreciate you. Bless you, amen, corner. Bless you all. Now, we'd like to say good evening once again to each one of you. It is certainly good to be here to share this time with you. We're here for one reason, and that's to uplift the name of Jesus Christ. because he indeed is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. It's been a while since we've been able to be with you. The last time the snow was so deep and so cold, wasn't able to get out, so we had him to play a tape, but it's good to be back with you this evening. I know that there's many says we hadn't saw you in a while and been looking for you and whatever else here on television, and it's a joy to come and to share an hour with you because we're here to praise God and lift his holy name, and that someone through it all might be saved or strengthened and encouraged in their Christian life. Now, this program wouldn't be possible if it wasn't for the prayers you folks send up and for the financial services you give to this broadcast, because without you, it wouldn't be possible. And we thank God that we have this opportunity. And we're not here to beg for money, and we're not here to beg for anything. We're just here to tell you God's good all the time, and all the riches and glory belong to him. Now, I know there's been a lot of snow, a lot of rain, a lot of people sick, and I've seen a lot of people that, good friends of mine, that the Lord's been calling out to be with him. And when I get to thinking about all the funerals, hospital visitations, the nursing home visitations and all, then I get to thinking about heaven. Sometimes I just got to stop for a minute and think about heaven. Just sit back and relax and just think about how wonderful it's going to be when all the problems and trials and heartaches of this world is over forevermore. So if we put our faith and trust in the Lord and the Lord alone, my great and wonderful things are about to happen. If you have your Bibles, they're close at hand tonight. We'd like for you to turn over to the book of Revelations. We want to read a few verses of Scripture from the 21st chapter of the book of Revelations. We may even read a few out of the 22nd, because this material is so good. God's Word is renewed every day. Just as he said, these physical bodies grow old and get weaker, but the spirit's renewed daily. And when I get to thinking about God and all of his wonderful creation and all of the things that he's created for the future, my, I get excited from within. I rejoice from within knowing that the problems and trials of this world is just a small thing compared to what Christ had to go through to give us eternal life. Revelations chapter 21, beginning with verse 21. And the 12 gates were 12 pearls. Every several gate was one pearl, and the streets of the city was pure gold, as it were transparent glass. And I saw no temple therein, for the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are the temple of it. And the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon, to shine in it, for the glory of God did lighten it, and the Lamb is the light thereof. And the nations of them which are saved shall walk in the light of it, and the kings of the earth do bring their glory and honor into it. And the gates of it shall not be shut at all by day, for there shall be no night there. And they shall bring the glory and honor of the nations into it, and there shall in no wise enter into it anything that defileth, neither whatsoever worketh abomination or maketh a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's book of life. Let us bow our heads for a moment of prayer. O gracious and wise Heavenly Father, as we enter your presence this evening, Lord, we thank you for your holy word. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to stand before your children. And Lord, we pray that those that are watching tonight, that Lord, they open their hearts and minds to your word and open their heart and mind to you, Lord. And just slow down a little bit and think about the greatness of you, Lord, and what you are preparing for them to love you. We know and realize, Lord, there's many problems and trials in this world. But, Lord, we know and realize that there's great splendor and glory in the world to come. Lord, we ask if there's one tonight that's lost without you, that they'll call on your name for salvation. Bless those who have lost loved ones tonight to eternity. And, Lord, we do look forward to heaven one day. And for all these things we ask in Jesus' name, and amen and amen. Looking at this passage of Scripture tonight, we can see and realize that God has everything under control. With the problems of all the wars and rumors of wars that there are in the Middle East, of all the division and all the arguing that is even here in our own country, we see that it's election year and it's one debate after another and one fellow running the other down. And, you know, we should be encouraging and strengthening one another, knowing and realizing that, folks, we're in this together. And there's a lot of people who believe, well, I have to be this denomination, that denomination, that over there. Folks, I'm telling you, you must be born again. It says here that I read in your hearing that they which are written in the Lamb's Book of Life, they are the only ones that's going to make it into heaven. And it doesn't matter that what stature of life you might be in, doesn't matter how many millions of dollars you do or don't have, doesn't matter what kind of car you drive. What matters is that your name's written in this book of life. And when you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, then this place that's called heaven is going to be a wonderful place to spend eternity. You and I don't realize really what heaven's going to be like, because the Scripture tells us clearly that I have not seen, ear hath not heard, neither has entered into the heart of man what God has prepared for them to love Him. And even with the snow that came, you know, there's beauty in that. And maybe we couldn't get out and get around where we wanted to be. But I'm telling you that that old snow hanging on them old trees is just so beautiful. And I know and realize that the day that I asked Jesus Christ to come into my life, He cleansed me and purified me by His blood to make us fit for heaven. And there's no other way but by the way of the cross. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by Christ, in Christ alone. It says here that the gates of the city is going to be one pearl. My, you just want to, now I've seen pearls, you know, about the size of your thumbnail, maybe not as a begging, but you think about a whole gate that's made of one pearl. That's going to be a beautiful thing to see. And it doesn't say what its hinges it's going to be hung on or how it's going to be fastened. But by the power of God, it's going to be there and it's going to be swung outward and it's never going to be closed, because it says here that it's not closed by day and it never comes night in heaven. Because the brightness of God is so great, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit in that city won't need the sun, won't need the old moon anymore, won't need to light a candle, won't need to try to find a flashlight when the power goes off. Because, folks, the power is going to be so great that you're going to be able to see all the time. Your new immortal body is never going to get tired. It's going to be a pleasure to work for the Lord throughout eternity. I don't know what job He has for me to do, but as old David said, I believe it was, or the psalmist said, I'd rather be a gatekeeper for the Lord than I would to live in the palaces of the wicked. If I knew that this life here was all there was to it, I'd still want to serve God. I'd still want to be part of His family. But I know that there's much more, because God is sure in His promises. He's not slack in any one of them. And we look at the beauty that we see today in the snow and the rain and the moon and the stars and all of these things. And my, the splendors of glory are even greater. It says here that the streets are of gold, so clear and so transparent that you're able to see right through them. I don't know what we're going to see when we look down at the old ground and see that, but I believe there's going to be beautiful fields of green grass. I believe that, as the next chapter says, there's going to be a crystal clear river flowing down from the throne of God. Now, I live up close to the river, and I was looking out the other morning at the old river, had the ice there, and some ice chunks floating down, and some of the old rocks you go out there and sit on in the summertime and put your feet down in that water. It always feels good to just put your feet down in the old cold water there along the river somewhere, and just think about the greatness of God, and just thank Him for putting that river there. You know, I get to thinking about the greatness of God, and I get to thinking about what God has prepared for me. It's like an old story was one time about an old fellow that sung in the choir, and they decided that because he was shouting so much and missing a word once in a while. You know, I remember laughing at old brother Ped Lewis and Claude Lewis. You know, you never know where they're going to be singing. They'll be singing the same song as you, but it may not be the same verse. And many times people ask me that now. Preacher, are you singing the same song you're singing? Well, I suppose I am, or I'm certainly trying to. Because a lot of times I don't hear very well what where they're at or what's taking place. But I can hear the presence and feel the presence of God as well. I know that God is forever near. And this old fellow was singing in the choir. And he'd get excited and start praising the Lord. And some of them at the church thought, well, he disrupted the service. We're just going to have him not to sing anymore. And they sent the preacher out there and he walked up and he stood there by the old fence line and he saw the old boy plowing back and forth to his own mule. And he stopped there and waved his old brow. And he was sweating pretty good. And he said, "Preacher, what in the world can I do for you today?" And he said, "Well," he said, "I was sent here to tell you that you couldn't sing in the choir anymore because you're just disrupting things, not being able to sing in the right place and just shouting and carrying on, and you're just not going to be able to." And the old fellow wiped his brow again. He said, "Preacher," he said, "I'm sorry. I'm sorry that maybe I disrupted the service." But he said, "You know, I get to thinking about God. I get to thinking about the Holy Spirit, and I begin to think about the gates of pearl and streets of gold, and I begin to think about how there's no more heartache, no more pain, and no more hospitals, and no more doctors, no more shots, no more operations." And he said, "Here, preacher, hold these lines. I'm going to have to shout. Glory be to God. It's time for us to think about heaven and to think about the things that are eternal. We've so many of us got our mind on the things of this world and maybe accumulating wealth, and the only wealth that you'll ever have is that in heaven, because it's with you forever. I've never seen a U-Haul behind a hearse, and I don't think anybody would dig a hole deep enough and wide enough to put it in if you got it out to the cemetery. Folks, it's time for us to know and realize that God is still in charge of everything today. He's in charge of your life and mine, and we are predestined to one day make the decision whether to accept Christ or whether to reject him. You know, this evening we could have just laid back in that old recliner and just took a nap, but the house was nice and warm. At nights when I go to bed, I thank God for that old dry and soft bed, and it's so warm in there, and you know, I thank God for allowing me to have such a good place to sleep. Not because I deserve it any more than anybody else, but God abundantly blesses those that are faithful to him. And we all have our problems and trials along the way, but none of us will ever, ever have to go through what Christ went through for us. We think about heaven, and I think sometimes about the Garden of Eden. How sad it must have been when Adam and Eve had sinned and they were cast out of the Garden of Eden, because you and I can't remember what the Garden of Eden was like because we wasn't in there. All we can do is read about it. But I'm sure that Adam and Eve looked back many times toward the old Garden of Eden and said, "How in the world could we have messed up so bad?" Well, now I know how that feels, because many times I've got to go back and get on my old knees and say, "Lord, I'm sorry. How in the world could I have listened to the old devil and sinned the way I did?" And God says, "Listen, son, I've got you covered by my blood that was shed on Calvary. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." And that means every one of us. Today is the day of salvation. If you want to live in this place that's called heaven, you're going to have to accept Jesus Christ. Because if you don't, there's another place that is prepared, and it's a place of torment and heartache and sorrow. He says there'll be weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth. You'll be cast into outer darkness where you'll burn throughout eternity. And no, it's not God that sends you there. You choose to go on your own. So today, I give you an alternative to this place that's called hell. I give you an alternative to the things of this world. And the turmoil that's within it, the uncertainty that is here. Well, these things that I've told you about this evening, they're certain. They're just as certain as I'm standing here before you this evening. If you accept Jesus Christ, someone told me the other day, You know, he said, how do you know you're saved? How do you know that heaven's your home? Do you know beyond the shadow of a doubt? Yes, I believe that with all my heart. If I didn't believe that tonight, I wouldn't be here. There wouldn't be no need to. But I believe that one day the trumpet of God shall sound. The dead in Christ shall be brought forth. We which are alive and remain shall be called up to be with him there in the air. And my, what peace and joy and contentment there's going to be in heaven. When we see all the saints that's went on before, a lot of the funerals that we preached over the last 30 years, a lot of good friends of mine that the Lord's called out, I know that they're in my future, not in my past. If people talk about losing someone, well, no, they're not lost. We know where they are if they know Christ. And folks, there's nothing I can do to bring them back. But we can live to go to be with them one day. And one day that call will come for us. And I want to be ready. I want to be ready to meet him, cleaned by and purified by the blood of Christ. All of us are just sinners saved by grace and ask Jesus to be Lord of our life. If you're there tonight and you've never accepted Christ, I urge you to do that. It's the most important decision that you will ever make. We need to pray one for another and encourage and strengthen and uplift one another. They brought me the prayer request, and I want to share those with you this evening. On the prayer list tonight is Julie McDaniels, May Collins and family, Randy Collins, Lonnie Collins, Ethel Simons, Mary Godfrey, Brand, Dakota Tharp, Nathaniel Russell, Mary and Johnny Russell, Tom Reed, Christy Wilfon, John Abels, Glenna Tenney, Ernest Shirley Gifford and the grandkids, Gene Starr, Emma Zickafoos, all the residents and staff at Holbrook's, Bob and Janice Bennett, Dave and Betty Gould, Dave Convier and Betty Wengler. We down by the other day. It didn't look like maybe there was anybody home. Dave, we'll stop by first chance we get. For Daphne Newland, Louise Hamner, Betty Harvey, Mary Brown, Ann Brown, all of the military, our schools. Yeah, we need to pray that we'll have school here before long. I've seen they called it off again today, but we want the kids to be safe. For all of the ministers, for Israel, for Cat Channel and family, Clifford and Krista Golden. Krista, we've been praying a lot for you. God bless you. For our country, for President Obama, for June Hurst, Brenda Anderson, Werlin Tenney, Darlene Cutright, Juanita Wilson, Charlie Reed, Rodney Irvin Sr., for Toots Bennett, for Opal Hill, Thelma Carpenter, Keith Gillum, and all the folks that we know that has cancer and physical problems, for Jesse Brown, Wayne Smith, Kathy Smith, for Lauren Campbell, Charlotte Hall, Norma Sines, Roger Sines, Paula Tenney and family, Jerry Wallet and wife, Charlotte Lewis, for Lou Vest and Timmy Wolford and Amanda Bell, and for the lost, and for Grandpa in Ohio. We want to remember many others. We want to remember the Perry family. Sharon's having some surgery or had it, and we just know that everyone needs to be encouraged and strengthened. For the ones that we normally mention here on the broadcast, and many that are not written here, that we do pray for, that God will touch you and bless you, fill every need that you have. Trust in him. He will never, ever let you down. But if you're there tonight and lost, as we have this prayer, ask Jesus to be Lord of your life. And I assure you that you'll find joy that you never thought possible. Let us pray together. Father, as we enter your presence once again, we thank you for the words that have come so freely this evening, Lord. And we pray that we'll remain faithful in your work and your service till the day you come to receive us unto yourself. And Lord, we pray for everyone that's on this prayer list tonight and all those, Lord, that we normally mention. Lord, you know who they are. And Lord, you know what their needs are. And most of all tonight, we pray that you would touch those that are lost. Any one person or many that's calling on your name for salvation, Lord, we ask that you'd forgive them right now. as you promised you would. We cast all of our cares upon you, and we thank you, Lord, for touching and blessing people, and Lord, that they give in prayer and finances to this broadcast, Lord, that we're able to preach the gospel and sing the old-fashioned songs that'll bless their heart and ours as well. Amen. And for all these things we ask, in the sweet name of Jesus we pray, and amen and amen. God bless you, folks. You all come back and take us off the air.
I'll sing with us. We've got a request there.
Pastor, Richard Day called in.
All right.
He wants us to sing. He wanted you and Theodore to sing. And now he thought it was On the Wings of a Dove that his mom went around humming. But Theodore says it's Sweet By and By.
Sweet By and By, yeah.
Okay. Well, he wants us to, because said it would be her birthday. That would have been her birthday on the 13th.
Yes.
Right?
Okay. Yes, that's right.
So, verse on
14. All right.
Okay, so we're going to do that.
All right, we'll sing that one. Or sing at it, one or the other.
Are you ready?
There's a land that is fairer than day. And by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there. In the sweet by and by, we shall be on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall sing on that beautiful shore the melodious song of the blessed, and our spirits shall sorrow no more, not a sigh for the blessing of rest. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. To our bountiful Father above, we will offer our tribute of praise. Oh, the glorious gift of His love, and the blessing that hallowed in the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
Amen. Bless you, Rich.
That sounds good.
All right, guys.
Well, I believe it's my turn now. I'm going to share about three songs with you, and then we'll turn it over to somebody else. And this first song I want to do tonight is The Blood Is Still There. You know, we're coming up on Easter before too long, one of the things that happened at Easter time was the Passover, the celebration of the Passover. And this song was about a little bit about the Passover. And I'd like to send it out to Cleo Wingfield, Vanny Cornell, Gus Allender, Teddy, Llewellyn Maynard Hannafin, Harold and Elsie Lewis, with Jesse Friend, and Ronnie and Janet Rogers, and the blood is still there. One dark night in Egypt, a fearful time had come for one little Hebrew boy who was his father's firstborn son. Now with the angel of death passing low, it was hard to fall asleep. But one little lamb stood in his mind as he lay there counting sheep. He wondered why the young lamb had to die, why his blood was on the door. through the wind and rain, had it still remained. But he wanted to be sure. So he cried out to his earthly father with a trembling voice so scared, crying, "Father, will you please look and see if the blood is still there?" And he said, "Son, now don't you worry, for the blood is there to stay. The wind may blow and the rain may fall, but it won't just wash away. The blood will stand the raging storm. It's been applied with loving care. Safe, secured, you can rest assured that the blood is still there." Looking over the damage Satan's storm had left behind, the flood of endless questions, doubt had filled my mind. The fear that gripped my troubled soul brought me back to my knees in prayer, crying, "Father, will you please look and see if the blood is still there?" And he said, "Son, now don't you worry, for the blood is there to stay. The wind may blow and the rain may fall, but it won't just wash away. The blood will stand a raging storm. It's been applied with loving care. Safe, secured, you can rest assured that the blood is still there. Safe, secured, you can rest assured that the blood is still there." Next song I want to do is "Since I Met You, Jesus." And you know, since I met Jesus, my whole life changed. It's just completely and wonderfully. I'd like to send this one out to Charlie Allen and his wife, Barry Beckner and his wife, and to Archie Snyder, my sister-in-law, Cheryl Chavis. It's "Since I Met You, Jesus." Since I met you, Jesus, my whole life has changed. Since I met you, Jesus, my whole life has changed. Everybody tells me that I'm not the same. I don't need nobody to tell my troubles to. I don't need nobody to tell my troubles to. Since I met you, Jesus, all I need is you. Since I met you, Jesus, I'm a happy man. Since I met you, Jesus, I'm a happy man. I just want to praise you any way I can. Since I met you, Jesus, my whole life has changed. Since I met you, Jesus, my whole life has changed. Everybody tells me that I'm not the same. Yes, everybody tells me that I'm not the same. Had a special request for Cat Channel. He sing "Flowers for Mama" for him, and he says he turned 95 last Sunday. My good buddy Cat. I tell you, he's just a blessing, and it's a blessing for me to sing this song for him because I know he likes it so well. It's "Flowers for Mama." Papa brought flowers for Mama today and all the grown children. But it's not Mother's Day. I don't have no money, not even a dime. But I brought Mama flowers like I have all the time. Each day I pick flowers from this pretty hill, a small bunch of daisies and a few daffodils. I bring them to Mama at the end of the day and say, flowers for Mama, here's Mama's bouquet. They'd brighten her face and she'd hold me so close. She'd say they were more precious than a beautiful rose. And she wore a smile sweeter than millions of flowers, a smile that I'll carry through life's darkest hours. Yes, Mama was lying there, and they told me that she'd passed away. And she was surrounded by flowers that outshine my bouquet. Oh, I know mine's not fancy, but still all the while, when they placed them in her hand, I know I saw Mama smile. Flowers for Mama, I picked them today. Not very much, just a simple bouquet. I know Mom's not fancy, but up there above, she's the prettiest flower in God's garden of love. Yes, she's the prettiest flower in God's garden of love. God bless you all and good night.
Amen.
There's a long black train coming down the line, beating off the souls that are lost in crime. Rail of sin, only evil remain. Watch out, breath, for that long black train. Look to the heavens, you can look to the sky. You can find redemption staring right back in your eye. There is protection, there is peace the same. Burn your tickets for that long black train. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. There's an engineer on that long black train, making you wonder if the ride is worth the pain. He's just waiting on your heart to say, let me ride on that long black train. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. Oh, I can hear the whistle from a mile away. I sound so good, but I must stay away. That train's a beauty, making everybody stare. His only destination is the middle of nowhere. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name, and don't go riding on that long black train. Just cling to the Father and His holy name, and don't go riding on that long black train. Just watch out, brethren, for that long black train. The devil's a driving that long black train.
Alrighty. I'd like to wish happy birthday. Tomorrow's Dad's birthday. See, Wednesday will be my son's birthday. like to dedicate this song to my dad, and also send it out to Mom and all the folks there at Holbrook's on the hill. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well. Request for Nathaniel Russell, the Old Rugged Cross.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners. my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true. It's shame and reproach gladly bear. Then you'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. So I'll share
you, and good night.